Hello everyone, NadLabs here, and today I'm going to really quickly show you how to import 3D pixel art. In this tutorial, I'm going to be using this Kenney 1-bit pack. I already have it downloaded, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to make a 3D scene. I'm going to obviously make a world, you know, source, save. I'm going to save it in the source folder. I'm going to add my Sprite 3D, so I'm going to go click this plus sign. I'm going to type in Sprite 3D, double click that, and then I'm going to drag in my asset. So my assets over here in my Kenney 1-bit tile pack, I'm going to drag and drop it. And if I double click it, and you know, if I just drag and drop it here real quick, nothing happens. But if I bring it into my Sprite 3D, you can see, you know, we have this sprite here, but it's really blurry. As you can tell, like if I go up to the edges, it's blurry. There's two reasons why it's blurry. First reason is I have to actually import project settings. If I go down to textures, it helps if I have nearest on. So nearest means it will create pixel art that isn't as blurry, because it just takes the pixel instead of, you know, blurring it or estimating what the color is. And then if I go over here to my Sprite 3D, I have to click flags. I have to go over here to my texture filter and I have to click nearest. As you can see, immediately my pixel art looks a lot more crisp and clean in 3D. And on top of that, if I want to have shadows for my pixel art, I'm gonna have to click alpha cut and I have to do opaque prepass. Now all these sprites would show a shadow, and honestly I could just show it as is straight up. So if I do just put in a mesh instance real quick, toss in a mesh instance, you can already see the shadow forming. It's not really good because Godot's default light system is really, it's not bad, but it's not the best. So if I just expand this box out a bit, maybe not on the Y dimension, but if I expand this box out, get rid of these default lights, and I put in a omni light here, drag my omni light up a bit, you can see that there's no shadow. But I actually have to enable shadows, and there we go, we have 2D pixel shadows. Honestly, I think I'd make this a thumbnail. It looks pretty sick. Like shadows like that. Oh my god, that looks pretty cool. I didn't even know Godot could do this. Because when I was experimenting with it, I just did one sprite. I didn't do the entire box. But, you know, this looks pretty cool, honestly. So I'm just gonna screenshot this. Yeah, and that's all I have to say for this tutorial. Oh my god, wait. No, that's pretty cool. What happens if it's a different color? No, that's really, really cool now. Okay, that's just a small exploration side bit, but you know, that's how you import 3D pixel art. Just make sure that when you click on your sprite, it's opaque prepass for the shadows, because if it's not, then you know, you don't get shadows. Even you could do half hash, but I find opaque prepass works a bit better, and then make sure your texture filtering is on nearest. That's all I have to say for this video. Thank you so much for watching, and have an amazing day.